Good afternoon to all of you. At the outset, on behalf of Director General, I like to thanks to organizer UNIDA ICMT for inviting me here and giving the opportunity to interact with the industry or the stalwarts of the industries present over here. From the few days talks, I mean yesterday, from yesterday and today's, what I could understand that to do anything, we must have our vision. Vision must be very clear. And to make our vision clear, probably we have to educate ourselves more. That is the theme so far I understood from the talk what was delivered so earlier. I am going to talk about the cut the market competition of plastics with technology age. The technology, how sharp, as Archana said, how sharp is the technology? If we adopt that sort of technology, whether we can exist at the prevailing stage of the market. That is how we are going to talk about that, what sort of kind of technology we should adopt and how we adopt. If we think that from the agriculture economy we have shifted to the service economy without bothering much on the manufacturing economy, and we have come to this stage of situation of today, then who are the responsible? As somebody told, we cannot make the other people like government responsible. Then who are the responsible? Let us see who could be the responsible person in pushing the technology forward. Earlier, manufacturing was defined as the production of goods, like in simple lathe deals, etc. But today, manufacturing is about ideas, products, processes, and services. It represents a complex and highly integrated value chain encompassing many things like cutting edge in science and technology itself. Innovation, skill, design, systems engineering, supply chain excellence, and wide range of intelligent services. This is the modern concept of today's manufacturing. Are we really sort of things? That is the questions we have to answer. Because the plastics is a global industry. What we are manufacturing here, manufacturing in other countries also. Demand of plastics will increase in long term because of the volume growth in developing markets such as in Asia. Why? Particularly in India, where the rural population is going to take a lot of products from your type of entrepreneurs. The price of commodity plastics will remain high as long as global demand increases and the oil prices stays high. This is likely to squeeze margins of the process unless they can pass on increased costs. They have to pass these costs. Environmental issue, already a significant factor for the industry, will continue to grow in corporate. And environmental regulations are like to remain a major cost to the industry. Changing attitude of customers may open up a new market for the recycled polymer materials. Energy is a major cost to the industry. Varying energy pricing in the different countries of the world is a serious obstacle to business competitiveness in the global market scenario. In global items terms, manufacturing is undergoing a transformational shift in that would reshape the driver of economic growth, wealth creation, national prosperity, and national security. What is the challenges? The biggest obstacle to growth today, how to develop, how to protect, and how to commercialize while they have to take their products, I mean industry has to take their product to the global market. These are the challenges. And because of our poor innovations, we are not able to do. It would be considered as a poor innovation of manufacturer which lack the skills to create, protect, and commercialize their valuable intellectual property. Need hand-on and real-world experience to overcome the problem and to manage the innovation process, achieve breakthrough commercial success, Many SMEs, they don't have these experiences. They have to understood that innovation is not mysterious, but a systematic process. Then, what is the methodical approach to approach systematically? If innovation is tackled methodically, it would help SMEs develop strategies for growth, innovatively provide skills, tools, and techniques for SMEs to drive revenue, grow profit, and reach global markets through commercial innovation. Innovation can be possible by backing with new technology. Art of the additive manufacturing must be practiced. Here is the one important factors what I talked to Gore, that today we do not know what is the additive manufacturing. Many industries not are practicing. How they can compete if that is not practiced? Only they heard the name, but nobody is practicing. How they can compete? So that is the additive manufacturing means what? The adding of the product or the creation of the product with the help of layer by layer structure to integrate a complete product. In manufacturing or machining, what we do? We remove the parts and bring to the product. So there is an opposite term. One is creation by build the layer of the product layer by layer, and other is removal by part. So this is the opposite concept of manufacturing, which is the first layer that is to be taken into consideration. Manufacturing based on market-driven opportunities, where you could be flexible, where you have the leverages more, find out that opportunities. Leading producer of knowledge to play a key role. Here, we have to think that what the educational institution, what the organization of like research and R&D institutions, or the best class R&D sectors can give to the industries. Leading producer of knowledge, best research institute, world-class education institution and legal community, well-versed buyers in international intellectual property, law will drive the best cutting-edge technologies, which can enable SMEs to compete in today's global economy. Innovation through high-tech technology, innovation in products and processes through high technology can cut through the global market, definitely, but how? Somebody was telling, so many product features. Today's generation, today's children, today's peoples, they need lot of options, lot of usable situations in their day-to-day working life. So if that is the requirement of the market, are we really positioned to serve that requirement to them? In that situation, I'll be asking here one question, who could be the better enterprise in this regard? If I really want to serve the customer in the way they want, I'll be giving the answer at the last of this session that who could be the best entrepreneur. It needs innovation in development. How will be developing? Innovation production cycle is often viewed as a linear and separate. In our country, we want to do something development and then forget. Leave it to the others, let him do the product development. Both are not integrated. We develop something here in R&D, then applied in R&D, and technology transfer, we try to do that, but that is not practice in the industry. Because whatever the reason, I do not know, because those are not integrated. So in this situation, you cannot innovate. You cannot really go to the challenging market. What you have to do? You have to integrate continuously in a cycle. That should not be linear. That is the concept you have to build in your day-to-day facilities. What is the climate you need to innovate? How the innovation will be coming? Suitable atmosphere for innovation? Is it available here? Is it the government forces available or the market forces available? Then how will be innovating? On which will be depend that you have to innovate and compete? Not government force, as Dr. Goh told, that government is not supporting, then who will be supporting? Do you want, to die here? So that is the things we have to think, then how will be surviving? Answer is people and the technology. Talented people. Who will be making you better in the market? How? You see the scenario, why you are not able to do it? Availability of talented people, scientists, researchers, engineers, and production workers, which is topping the list of the above slide, what I showed. If you see, talented people in the left side. Other thing I'm not bothering here, because I'm going to switch over to the next slide. See the scenario? In this scenario, how you want to bring a competitive edge in your industrial scenario in the country? This is the scenario, only 1% of the R&D people are working in your industry, plastics industry. Only 1% of the total population engaged in the plastics industry. How will you be able to do that? So, as I told that we need an ideal situation, that ideal situation cannot be created. We have to create that ideal situation. How? There should be a strong insight for the roadmap of entire manufacturing. Who is, as I told, the vision? Cost effectiveness, you have to decide according to that. And update with the new generation technology. Really, if you are not integrate your existing production with integrated new generation technology, you are far behind because obsolete technology nobody is taking. So you need product design innovation, material technology capability, manufacturing and supply chain management, which is not in many of the industries are not integrated. Product life cycle management and technology management. Few examples I'm keeping it, it's only for example. Then what is the challenges? Innovative proper product design. What are the challenges? Rambir Sabete is in front of me. In front of you, one bottle is there. How you want to innovate? What you are looking to innovate in this product? Without redefining the product. That is the thing we have to think of. If I don't redefine, again I will supply, and you have to supply, then how I have to define? That is the thing if you want to define, you have to decide, you have to target, then you are the winner. See, already some people have done. You never thought that we'll be switching over to some other product on the of the paid bottle. We are not redefining the product. We have changed. We have added the value in some other way. So that is the concept. If you want to develop, you have to go to R&D. You have to depend on the people. Manufacturing and supply chain management. There are a lot of things which I am not going to talk in detail because time was set less as she told. So I'll be just telling some of the important things. These are the tools if you really adapt in your practices of regular manufacturing, definitely one day, not suddenly it will be coming, because sudden coming need dynamics. You have to create a dynamics. That dynamics, if it is created already, you will be able to do that. If that dynamic capability is not created, it is very difficult, even if you adapt it. Product cycle management, you have to think how will be able to do that. Are you focusing all sort of things, requirement? These are the all management terminology. But after listening these words, after knowing these words, even if you don't do that, then how do you expect that you'll be able to compete? Why are you emphasizing on the vertical integration services here? Because without integration, without R&D integration, that is R&D integration, you cannot bring new system. Here I'll be giving one example. I'll be giving the answer or the question what I asked, who is the best entrepreneurs, that I'll be giving. You need not redefine your food. As mother is giving the child, mother is testing, change the taste of the food and giving to the child to satisfy the customer. Mother's customers is the child. Then have you adapted the technology of materials technology capability? Whether you have really have? You want to give a good finished product to your customers, but you don't adapt it technology like laser cutting. You want to have integrated sub product, but you have not adapted technology like water jet technology in your machining. So how that integrate, how that engineeringly precise product you will be able to bring in the market. So we have to upgrade all sort of facilities. We will be coming to the material aspects. You want a materials which will be behaving like this way, that water can roll on the surface to store more water without spillage of water, without leaking of water. How will we be able to do that? Have you perceived ever earlier that how will we be able to do that? So we have to think for the new technology, nanostructure material technology. How that we done? That itself is another problem. So these are the things which we are not able to adapt so far, and probably we have to look forward. Are you thinking for thinner product, that how we can make a thin mole product, like which has to be made from the nanostructure material, and what is the mole for that? How are we doing that? These are the questions you have to address. Light structure furniture, which will be needed for the aircraft, how are we doing that? So there is an opportunity to think in a different manner on the existing material. From the recycled material also you can try. There are advanced technology and anti-ballistic missile technology, where this sort of material, nanostructure material, is used for making very highly fire-retardant product and lighter product. See, after 30 seconds also nothing is happening. How will we be able to do that? Without the support of the R&D, or without the support of the knowledge, and without the support of the machineries, this is not possible. Dr. Jain told, because he's the automobile manufacturer, and I told the market of commodity plastics is growing, and he's afraid of. Sir, engine plastic will not be growing, I don't know. Not growing. It will grow, provided you grow right away. So this product is from reinforced composites. But still we are not satisfied with this product's performance. We have to switch over to the another products, which has a better performance than that. This is the nano-reinforced technology, nanomaterial reinforced technology. So used in car, in a lorry. We have not thought of this technology. This is touchscreen technology. We are using it, but we do not know where from it is coming. Who is manufacturing in India? Nobody bothers. Nobody is taking. And we have brought all the technology of TV, computer screen. We have brought your mobile phone, Samsung mobile phone, whatever it may be. But why from that is coming? Why is the science and technology behind it? Who can TV provide it? So these are the things. You are using a lot of cables inside this room. If anything fire takes place, who will be responsible? And they will be catching you. Environmental regulation authority will be catching you. Why are you doing without the authority permission? It is not in this country, but in other countries there. So we have to think for new cable of cables come from PPO material. I think you should have a look on this issue, because we are doing PPO material also. You want to manufacture biocomposite products? Commodity plastics based on base only PP or PP. Can we, somebody asked you this question, I have attended on interview. Can we replace the PP with this material? I don't know. I simply told no. Sir, this is biodegradable, that is not biodegradable. I told, biodegradable material, definitely green material, but they are not LCA ranking material of lower order. PP is a LCA ranking material of lower order, that's why you are not able to replace so far PP with any of the material, therefore PP has to stay. PP LCA ranking is one, and your polylactic acid or that sort of material is LCA ranking, maybe 2 or 3. So which is greener? As per IPCC, that means International or Intergovernmental Panel for Global Climate Change, PP is the acceptable. So when the regulation is permitting to be PP entering the competitor, how your biodegradable will be competing, although which is costly? We have to think for medical material products, for replacement of your bone, etc., or for tumor operation, some tissues. The material what you are looking for, that the growth period of the tissue is equal to decay period of the plastics inside the body. We have to think of that sort of material. We can replace by only a plastic, but really competitive material, that would be the competitive, because that is the demand of the market, that is called environmental and green material, and that is not happening means we cannot, even if we have the manufacturing capacity for different sort of product for replacement of bone, we cannot compete. Regulations. You know that you have to think for the paintless technology for manufacturing product, for removing the emissions from the manufacturing place. Another materials, engineering materials, which we are not developing for high engineering applications, for high pressure pipes, that also we have to think of if somebody is from the PP side or polyethylene side. Here I am giving this example. This we have is in developed in CFET. This is the lamp, emergency lamp for the military people in the field. You have seen this product. This product base was costly, based from ABS material body. Now, in order to economize the situation, what we have done, we have replaced it with the help of PP, HIPS. So we have to think that whether we can change with some other material, we can reduce the weight. So these are the simple things, very not difficult thing, but only thing you have to think in a proper way. This is a high-tech product. We are purchasing from our defense department in India, purchasing from abroad, from different countries. We are not doing it, such type of high-tech areas, applications, product. I don't know, for precise cutting in many sophisticated products or looking good products, we are not using the technology of cutting for making different sort of facilities inside the product or operating or putting switches, etc., and laser technology, one of the pioneer technology like in used in polycarbonate. Finally, you have to develop a product that there shouldn't be any failure of the product. What sort of manufacturing you should do? That is also a good manufacturing practices which will be adapted in your manufacturing technology of the mold. And also similarly to reduce the waste, your online technology of manufacturing in extrusion, online control. And also you need that your positioning the mold is perfect, your mold is free from any sort of contamination. If it is a vertical product, you should have a camera facilitated molding. One of the best technology today is coming in the market. I'll be showing that. You want to reduce, if you see there is a challenge, slide was there. I asked one question, what is the challenge? You want to reduce the bumper or reduce the dashboard weight. I asked this question there. Can we reduce the dashboard weight? Can further in a Ford car or maybe Honda car, can you reduce the dashboard or a bumper weight further? So that was the thing. If you want to do that, this is the technology, microcellular forming technology. I'll be showing the product. This is a microcellular injection molding technology, high pressure injection molding with supercritical fluid. Why you are telling this is a green technology? We are no other gases is using as like foam. We are using only nitrogen and carbon dioxide, which is available plenty in the atmosphere. So that is green. And weight reduction. You are reducing the waste. This is Mucel technology, and this is the way our product is getting fused, and you are getting the product. Of this kind. This is the bumper, this is the instrument panel in the Ford car, which is looking plastic like, but it's never plastic, so it's radium. Radius 20%, 30%. So it's different from the foaming. It's a high class technology, green technology, so called. And another thing is, which is all of you know, used basically for co-injection molding technology is used for having a coarse and skin structure material or product, where you can use recycled material as a core and use the recycling material usability. This is the slide what I was talking about, that how the biodegradable plastics always you thinking may occupy the market, but not so because of the LCA characteristics of the product, because LCA of the biodegradable material is, here is showing PLA is biodegradable, here is a green product it seems, but ranking You can see that ranking of PL is 1 or ranking of PP's LCA rank is 1. LCA PL is 6. So that is producing more pollution in the atmosphere than PP product, more carbon dioxide equivalent in the atmosphere than PP. That's why it's not economically replaced. Somebody told all people are using now recycled material, PET material for manufacturing our shirts, clothes, pants, etc. These are the shirts and pants for the basketball players. Come from your polyester, recycling of polyester bottles. Your recycled materials can go for house construction. Again, it's a controlled destiny by manufacturing by low pressure technology. Extrusion, profile. We are discussing about the electronics. Because with the electronics applications, a lot of plastics are used. And those are being created a pollution in the society. And how these plastics can be arrested. So, this recycling material can be used. That has been shown. This is a PBT material, which is used in most of the electrical applications, how those are being reused for manufacturing switches again, or the panels, or the plugs. We have been talking about the advanced machineries like co-injection molding, like blow molding, or etc., or injection molding, like microcellular injection molding. But other products, which is equally important, like thermoforming, is coming very vigorous way probably in future, because our most of the commodity products are sold through this technology, packing technology. And this is going to take a future place if you make it automation, if you make bring automation to this manufacturing, and somebody has done it already and being attracted, and so many customers are already in the line. I'll not tell this where from it has come. When we'll be doing recycling, you have to utilize all the technology available in front of you, all the science and technology cultured in this country through different research organizations, different institutions. And if you do something value addition of those recycled material, definitely you'll be having some kind of edge. Here is this mode is very important, I told. If somebody wants to do manufacturing of the recycled material, a very good looking, attractive, then definitely he has to think for, this is the rotation and this is a stack mold, this is not this mold, the other mold, this mold of rapid heating or cooling cycle molding technology. If you really want to survive with the biodegradable plastics, that I have to manufacture biodegradable product, then you should go this sort of mold, rapid heat and cooling cycle, because biodegradable product having very high viscous material, very difficult to process, and also to bring a better finish on the surface of the product, this is the one with the mold you can think of for biodegradable as well as recycled material. Then coming to the technology management cycles, when you are managing the technology, where you like to do your selling, where you are going to mature, where product is going to mature, and when you are going to sell out, you have to think of. See, without, this is the S-curve of the technology, how you are ascending, when you are getting the maturity, and when your deadline has come. You have to analyze this management very clearly